What's up and welcome back to Esports and Gaming Tonight with AJ Striker. This is my new podcast that I am dedicating to all esports entertainment groups and gamers alike. If you want to get your story out there, want the community to know exactly who you are, what you represent, and why you do it, please don't hesitate to contact me. And tonight, I have the UFN Federation, Ultimate Fight Night Federation, here with me. And it's been a wonderful experience getting to know these guys. But I have the CEO, head man in charge, Luger. Great conversation with this gentleman. He explains exactly why you should join, why he started, the ups and downs of the business itself. So let's get into it. Enjoy.
Hello.
Hey, what's going on? Can you hear me?
What is up, AJ Jack?
I'm chilling, man. I didn't know this was going to happen tonight.
I got to get through the violence and violence. You know what I mean? Got to give the savages what they want.
Yes. And Lord knows there's plenty of savages.
Definitely plenty of them. So, tonight, you get to interview Luke Luger, CEO of UFN. I can only imagine what questions you have to ask, but go right ahead. Fire when ready.
Okay, gotcha. Are we live now?
Yeah, we're live. Everybody here is hearing us.
All right, what's up, y'all? It is a pleasure to meet all of your acquaintance in person. Luke, of course, you know, you and I talk, and it is a pleasure, sir, to be able to do this for you, okay? Get you out here, man.
Gotta do the most or give the people what they want. It's all about giving the people what they want at the end of the day. And everybody in the UFN knows when you step through these doors, it's all about the fight, you know? It's all about that cage life.
Absolutely. But let's get to know you as a person first.
Okay, go ahead.
Before I get into all that good stuff. So, what is, and of course, you can omit anything that you don't want to let us know, but what is your age, your hometown? Give me some interesting facts about yourself.
Now, I'm going to ask you, is this in character or out? I'm going to let you decide. All right, out of character.
I don't know about the man.
Okay, the man. All right, definitely. So, we ain't talking about Luke Luger. We talk about, I'll just say, Warner, so to speak. Go ahead. From New York, Brooklyn. You know, born and raised in New York, Brooklyn. Went to school. I took up graphic design and, you know, decided to work for the city. You know, so I'm doing a lot of that. Got bachelor's degree and all that going on. And, you know, joined the community 5 years ago, I believe. And I believe there was something missing. And it was the savagery that you'd get from the old wrestling. I don't know if you've ever seen. Yeah. To me, it was more savage back then than it is now. And I didn't miss that, you know. So that's what led me here.
I agree. I think it's more for show now. It's more like.
It's entertainment.
High flying. Yeah. Acrobatics and shit. But.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think it needed to go back to, and you definitely deliver on that. What's your favorite NFL team?
Favorite NFL team? You know, I stopped watching a long time ago.
Whoa.
But my favorite was the Jets back then. I love the Jets.
Well, I understand Jets why you stopped.
Oh, wow. Really?
No, man. No, I'm just playing.
If you guys didn't know, AJ here has her own simulation football league going on. Well, it's not hers. You want to elaborate on that?
I will. And so basically, I have a podcast. I'm doing the second one, and I'll let y'all know about that one. This is what this interview is actually going to be on. But I am a quarterback for one of the simulation football leagues, one of their esports communities. And I do a podcast going over all kind of game day, play-by-play kind of things like that. And I do interviews, which is my thing. I love getting to know people, understanding why they make the decisions that they make to do certain things, all that good stuff. So I figure it'd be good for me to get you on the hot seat a little bit.
Me of all people.
Yeah, you,
I'm hard
absolutely.
to get to, so.
Well, I appreciate that, brother. I really do. I really do. But tell me, what was your, besides the savagery that you thought was missing, was there any other reason that you decided to go with the UFN?
Well, actually, it was something that me and my friend did. We were kind of I don't know, he's kind of making fun of wrestling, so to speak. And there was a few wrestlers we made, and we had the goofy voices and commentating and so on and so forth. And he's not with us anymore, but he wanted, he just wanted it to blow up. He wanted it to continue. He wanted it to move on. So I picked it up after I put it on Twitch. It was on YouTube for a while, and then I just turned it over to Twitch and I started doing it for a while. And then I had to stop because, I was going to school. Like, didn't want to give people half-ass work. I actually wanted to pour my all into the product you see now. And so I had to stop for a while. I think it was in 2K19. No, 2K, in the beginning of 2K19, I stopped. And then I picked it back up, and here we are. I just have a passion for it. I like to watch the fights more than anything. There's always a little story here and there, not so much as you'd get from your other eFeds, but the one thing that I always wanted to do was give new people opportunity. It didn't matter who you are or where you came from. I wanted to give people the opportunity to be in the spotlight and to get titles and get their name out there and get well known. Have them fight against people that they never thought they'd fight against, it's a big community. I mean, we literally have people that have made a name for themselves, that have taken on people and got championships and did do video editing, making great storylines all over the place. But you have these other guys who never get the chance to fight these guys. You hear about them, but you never get the chance to fight them. You want to fight these guys so bad. And it's like there's always that invisible wall. It's like, damn, I'm never going to get to put my hands on this guy. So, me, I wanted to create a platform where it didn't matter who you were, it didn't matter where you were from. You'd get the opportunity to fight the guys, the top guys, the vets in the business that we like to call them, the Ricky Browns and the Liam Mercers and the Oliver Windsors and the Seth Broughts, and the Jada Storm. These are guys that are well known in the community, and people are getting the opportunity to fight them, put them to the test.
Right. And you can appreciate that, right? Because I don't know anybody in this chat, in this league, that's really gonna go ahead and take these blows for real.
No,
So,
definitely not. I mean, I don't know. You got a few of them that'll probably do it. You got a few of them.
bro,
I know
listen.
K9 for a couple years. He's been doing this in real life. K9, if
No.
you're there, yeah, K9's been in the ring in real life. He's a real life backyard wrestler. He knows these moves. He could put you in probably any one of these moves. I known him from college. Good guy. Great guy.
Yeah, but is K9 willing to be put in those moves? I'm sure he
I'm
don't want to
Believe me,
feel
I'm sure he's been putting those moves through dealing with backyard wrestling. I'm pretty sure he's been in an
that.
arm bar or two. But,
I bet. But I mean, yeah, and I definitely
and
commend you for
Rigoni.
that.
Oh, sorry. And Rigoni. I see you, Rigoni. I'm gonna mention you. And Rigoni, he's a tough bastard. So there you go.
Dope, man, dope. Tell me about your character, Luke
Luke,
Luger. How did you come up with them? And yeah, basically, how did you come up with that character?
it's funny because Luke wasn't the guy. He was if you if I deleted my YouTube channel a long time ago, but when I started, I was just playing the game. I was just playing the game on YouTube and beating the living hell out the computer. I just beat them and beat them and beat them bloody. And it started out with Madman Max Brooks. That was my very first call. And the game deleted it. It deleted everything. And I said, all right, well, I'm just going to make a spoof off of Lex Luger and call him Luke Luger. So that's what I did. And I can say, the first couple people that got in contact with me was CM Puma, actually. I got in contact with CM Puma, and he at the time, I'm not sure what he does now, but at the time, he's big YouTuber with the wrestling games, and he got in contact with me, and he's like, hey, I like your character. I want to put him on my show. And I was like, sure, okay, fine, whatever. And that was my first eFed. I joined that with a gentleman called Ryan King and Oliver Windsor. And Oliver Windsor's a big name. That was my first rivalry. So when I came out with Luke, it really wasn't to be blown up as big as is now, as is today. It was just like, he was a spoof off of Lex Luger. But I was such a fan of the MMA style. I'm a big Brock Lesnar fan, Ken Shamrock, Steve Blackman. Those are the guys I look up to. Kurt Angle, the submission guys. So,
yeah,
you know, that I get my inspiration from those guys, a couple UFC fighters. You know, Kimbo Slice was my love. Kimbo. Loved Kimbo. When I saw his street fights, rest in peace to him. But that's where I got you, Luke Luger. And that's where I got my break. And I was doing the shows. I didn't even know what a promo was. I wasn't even doing promos. I was sitting at home yelling at the screen. And that was about it. And, you know, they said, oh, well, you come out with a Twitter page. I'm like, what? Why would I come up with a? I was like, whatever, fine. Came out with a Twitter page. And all of a sudden, I started getting follows. And I'm just like, this is weird. Okay. And that's how I got introduced to the community. And it's funny, Liam Mercer got in contact with me. He saw my character, and he said, hey, you want to go this place I know? I know this place. You'd be really, really well off there. And I said, okay, I've already started. So whatever, fine. I didn't notice. I still don't know nothing about all of this. And I'm sitting on Twitch, and I'm watching my guy fight people, and I loved it. I just had a love for it, just sitting there watching my guy fight people, even though I took a hell of a lot of losses. And you know, you're fighting against people now that know what they're doing, as opposed to you just slapping moves on your character. And it's a science. It's definitely a science, and it's a learning that you just sit there and watch. But yeah, that's how I came up with Luke, you know.
With kind of segueing into my next question about that, mm-hmm. When one is creating a character, what is important to pay attention to? Because if, let's say, you don't have any experience, but you do want to create one, you can put a whole bunch of move sets that's not going to get you anywhere. That's not going to get you, or even create your character in such a way that's just not going to be a contender. And there are times, even when I'm fighting here, it's like I'm noticing that these chicks are like Amazons, and I'm like so small. So when I created my character, I wanted her to be fast. I wanted her to be quick and hit you hard. But it just seems like these chicks just throw me around like a rag doll. So for those that don't necessarily know what to do, would you help them?
I've helped a good couple of people, and but nothing is like learning yourself. Nothing is like that. I've learned through trial and error. There was a lot of times I was, like I said, in the beginning, I was losing. I would lose every match I lost. And at first I was just like, I'm not doing this shit anymore. You know what I mean? Like, this is crazy. What the hell? I'm gonna take my ass to a real gym and beat up people. But I took the time, and with every match I lost, I'd watch how I lost. I'd watch the moves that were reversed. I'd watch the moves that are hitting, and even regular moves. I watched the regular moves. I paid attention to the whole entire match from beginning to end, every single move, from the ground moves to the grapples. And I'm not a master by any means. I just was watching. And I took notes, and, you know, I took a couple people's advice, And boom, you know, I was able to learn. I was able to really learn from paying attention. It's all about paying attention. And also, it's what you want out of your character. What do you want out of your wrestler? What do you want out of your fighter? Do you want them to punch people in the face? Do you want them to kick, you know, throw kicks? What do you want for your character? You have to have a foundation of what you want your character to do, and then you build from there. That's the best way I could tell you.
All right, gotcha. What do you think about the current reigning champs? Well, it looks like a lot of them lost their belt tonight.
That's the thing with UFN. Our champs work. Our champs don't sit down in the back. They don't gloat. You know, they don't just sit there. I don't allow that. You know, other people may do that. Other people may give their champs free reign, not me. If you're here and you're a champ, you are going to fight. If you're going to fight anybody and everybody, because this is what this is about. It's a fight. It's not a wrestling match. You know, you got your showboats. I know a couple showboats in the chat. You got some people that like to tell a story, and that's fine. But at the end of the day, it's what goes on in that cage. And that will tell everybody else what you're about. And if you're not willing to do that, you're in the wrong place. You know, it's what it is.
Gotcha. You know, gotcha.
I try to keep it simple, you know. I think I give plenty opportunities. You know, I give opportunities to everybody. What you do with your career is up to you. Mm-hmm. You know, it's up to you. It's not up to me. I mean, well, it is to give you that moment, but at the same time, I'm paying attention to what you do. If you're going on the Twitter, if you keep talking your shit, if you're representing the company, if you on it all the time, you're in the stream, you're dedicated. If you're dedicated, I can't ignore that. I'd be a fool to ignore that. You get on the mic, you record your promos, you constantly shooting for a title, and you don't give up. You don't give up. I took somebody under my wing a year ago, named Jeff Vendetta. Jeff has got to be one of the guys I've never seen this before. Me and a good friend, Al, we beat the hell out of him. We beat the shit out of Jeff in a place, you know, and he got up and he wouldn't quit. He was humble about his loss, and he just wouldn't quit. He just said, I'm going to get you next time. I was like, are you out of your mind? You just got the ass kicked, you know? Like, I think you should stop. You know, I got other cars, too. I got Bobby Legend. You know I got Bobby, the son of Luke. You know, I got CJ Tyson. You know, these are cars that I've made over the years. They're all related in some way. I like to keep it like that. But Jeff was humble. He didn't get upset. I like it.
Hey, I'm here for him, man. If anybody want to do it soon, just let me know. Y'all can be on the same show as this one. Other than that, you know, my show is actually to give you a platform too. So that's why, as soon as I came here, I knew I liked you for some reason.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I appreciate Absolutely. It. You know,
and I see what you're doing. So that's, and it's cool. It really is. But yeah, anybody that want to be on, y'all just hit me up, you know, DM me. I will be happy to have you on. I like to deal with the person behind the character, always have. We'll definitely talk about your character. If you want to come on and be in character when you start, and then we kind of move on and that, you know, we can do that. But
she gets that. She covers both sides. Great.
There you go.
Different.
That's right. That's right.
I mean, hell, we'll have an interview show for you if that's what you want. I don't got any problems with that.
Oh, okay.
And not.
All right, we'll talk more about that. We'll talk more about that for real. Oh. But it was a pleasure, man. And I know you got to get up and get out of here. You know, I know you got to work in the morning. So I really appreciate you for making time for me, brother. And I'm looking forward to it.
I appreciate this. Thank you. I really do appreciate it. It's an honor. and definitely check out her program. Her, what's your program? The SFL? The SFL, right? I didn't want to screw it up.
You're right.
Check out that SFL, guys. When she puts that in the chat, definitely put, and you know what the UFN is all about. When you hit this chat, you put your link up and you share it with everybody, you know.
I'll be happy to.
Yes, please do.
And I don't know if I finished my statement earlier, but I am doing another podcast where I am featuring different esports leagues, whether it be baseball, race car, wrestling, fighting, anybody that wants to come on and just kind of share their story and how they want to do it, you know, why they chose to do what they're doing, please do. And I'm also interviewing gamers too, so it's going to be pretty dope.
Gamers, that's good. That's good to have a voice for the gamers. I know there's a lot of guys in there in the chat that would love that. A lot of girls too.
Absolutely. But all right, brother. I'll see you around.
All right, lady. Take it easy. Thank you for this opportunity. And
no, thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. But we're gonna get going. It is four, it is going on 5 in the morning. Folks, y'all take it easy. I'm going to hit that music, and we're going to look for somebody to raid real quick. Thanks again, AJ. Yeah. Glad talking to you. We're going to hit you with the tunes, folks. While we figure out who we raided. What's up?
Cornelius 85 and hits V Glocky. Trust me, I make the interviews very easy. You won't suck with my interview.
Okay. Hey, she was easy on me. So,
yeah,
thank God. Tonight she was easy on me. I gotta loosen up the tie next time.
Yeah, you gotta ease into it. Then you go for the kill. You already know.
Oh,
you
shit.
See me play Mafia?
Oh, God. Check out her Mafia 3 stream, guys. She is brutal. She plays on the highest difficulty. It's vicious. But we're gonna head on out, guys. We're gonna hit the tunes. We're going to search for someone to raid. Thanks again, AJ. Good fight.
Absolutely, man.
Good night, folks. Take care. I'm going to get y'all some music right now. We're going to head on out.
This is...
Yeah. Let's get it. Take a break, so... Hey, Shiri, I'm coming. Let's get it.
It's lit.
Lit.
Just take a look at the drip. You boys don't get fired in this. Roll a dope, yeah, I'm high as a bitch. Wait.
It's We're gonna take the raid over the dingo.
Now she wanna suck on the dick. She wanna catch all of the drip. 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 Pull up and I'm loading the clip. New bitch, yeah, stay on my hip. Niggas talking, they not with this shit. Catch a body, you might get hit. But lately been all about drip. New designer, just look at the fit.
I want y'all to show y'all love my bitch. The dingo man.
But you don't got the drip.
You playing that MLB.
I can blind you, bitch, look at the wrist.
About to raid this guy.
Don't get crushed.
Show him all that UFN love, folks.
I'm trying to get lit. Trying to get out my body and shit. Fuck around and start bodying shit. Remember nights we were starving and shit. You my brother, I got you, that's it. We can never fall out by the bitch. We was swimming with sharks and them fish.
Good fight tonight, guys. Glad to have y'all with us.
Niggas be lying and
y'all
shit.
Stay care.
Talking money, don't buy they on shit. Baby mothers be buying them shit. You not lit, you depend on the bitch. Swear to God, man, I'm clever as shit. Still can trap any weather I'm in. Throw me work and I'm making it flip. With a whippy, you might get sick. Throw me extra, you know we gon' win. Getting money, I've been doing this. Since a youngin', I've been had to drip. Make a movie, not talking a clip. It's lit. Just take a look at the drip. You boys don't get fired in this. Roll a dope, yeah, I'm high as a bitch.